EA Sports. It's in the game.
I just ran a checkup on myself. Some days I just have to check up on myself. I'm so icy, got that GG on my belt. Thank the Lord for my people and my health. Lost a lot, but I came out with no L's. Thank the Lord for my people and my health. And I'm fine as hell from my head down to my nails. My man tripping cause I got another cell. He still buy me YSL. I could get it by myself. I could get it by myself. I'ma get it by myself, yeah. Feel like Ginger from Casino. Aces up my sleeve, though. Right before I leave, I said like I'm Dino. Think I'm part Italian, blame it on Gino. Snowflake the medallion, the skin on cappuccino. I don't kiss and tell, keep your distance from myself. Had a genie with the snails in a five-star hotel. And I wish these well when they wish for me to fail. I might donate petty bills, they can't get it by theyself.
That's why I treat my men good, but not too good. I give them too much, then they don't need me.
Yeah, I just ran a checkup on myself. Some days I just have to check up on myself. I'm so icy, got that GG on my belt. Thank the Lord for my people and my health. Lost a lot, but I came out with no L's. Thank the Lord for my people and my health. And I'm fine as hell from my head down to my nails. My man tripping cause I got another cell. He still buy me YSL. I could get it by myself. These d- I could get it by myself. By myself.
With Charles Davis, as always, I'm Brandon Gaudin. Charles, you talk about storylines in this one. I think it begins and ends with our two quarterbacks, certainly two of the best in the business.
And nowadays, I don't think you can get by for long periods of time without a top-flight quarterback. The way the game is played, with all the responsibility he has and how the game flows through him, if he's not on the top of his game, your team's not going to benefit at all.
Here's the kicker, Zane Gonzalez, ready to get this one started. And we are underway from Atlanta. This will be taken very short.
Here we go. 10 Nova.
Hey, pick it up, defense. Let's go.
Out. Defense.
The first carry for the legend. It's Bo Jackson. 5 yards on the game's first play. Second down. And on the tackle, Kevin Green, of course, a member of the 2016 Hall of Fame class, Charles.
Went in on August 6th of 2016. Kevin Green taking his rightful place in the Pro Football Hall of Fame. And what a speech he gave that night. I can still see him standing up there. And the line that resonated for me, I didn't play this game for any other reason than love and passion. And only a cynic would dispute that if they saw Kevin Green play.
Switch gears.
Now a give, right side. It's Jackson, and down he'll go at the 25. That one, a first down pickup of 8.
And there we see an early burst that makes him one of the leading rushers in the league.
Well, I want you to know, I listened to you yesterday when we were watching film. You said write down the word vision for him. It was on display there, wasn't it?
It certainly was, because he allows the blocks to set up in front of him. And if that continues, it could be a long afternoon for those guys trying to play some defense.
They run on first down with Jackson. He'll have a a first down past the 40. A big one there for the Jags. 18 yards, first down.
And that's a run that'll energize an offensive line. They'll take that one all day long. Fundamental breakdown by the defense. You've got to be able to make plays on the edge.
Hey, Charlie.
They go play action here on first down. He's going to float this one deep right. And this is caught inside the five. Touchdown, Jaguars. Randy Moss, 56 yards, as his guys are able to strike first here in this opening quarter. Zane Gonzalez on for the extra point. And this is up and good. The score now 7-0 Jaguars. Now after the touchdown, here's Gonzalez on to kick it away. That's fielded in the end zone. And no run back here. This will be a touchback, and it comes out to the 25-yard line. Carry here for Todd Gurley, and he will lose yardage here back at the 23-yard line. That's going to go as a loss of two, and it'll be second down.
Nice play right there to stop him behind the line, but I want to see how this defense continues to play him here in the first half.
Yeah, we know, you know better than I, he has the ability to take over a game, so what do you do?
Yeah, I think you have to.
Well, this is taken in, it's complete. And he finally goes out of bounds across the opposite 40. It's a big play there for Atlanta. And even 40 yards. On first down, it's Gurley. And brought down, but not before they're inside the 25. 12 yards is the pickup. Good for a first down for the Falcons. Fake on the give here as they try the run pass option. Completes it to Benjamin. 17 more yards on that one as they keep the drive rolling.
I like the screen being called here early in the game, especially on the opening drive, because, Brandon, when guys come out of the locker room, especially those pass rushers, they are so amped up to get to the quarterback that you can use that against them, and a screen pass is a great way of doing it. A lot of teams against good pass rushing teams, they want to run the screen 10 to 12 times in a game.
First and goal, and a chance to get that initial touchdown right back. On first and goal, Gurley. And that'll move him a little closer as he takes it from the 7 down to the 4-yard line.
And that's one of the reasons you like to blitz even on rundowns. It confuses the blocking assignments. It doesn't allow those offensive linemen to get up to the second level.
Now a fake on the give here as they try the run pass option. And he will score. Touchdown, Falcons. Taking it in from 4 yards out as his guys are on the board here in this first quarter. Gonzalez able to tack on the PAT, and we are tied at 7. Each team's had it. Each team has scored. 7-7 here as the kick's away. That's fielded in the end zone. And he's up past the 20 to the 22-yard line. Jaguars come to the line to start their next drive. And for them, a touchdown their last go around. Obviously, they'll be hoping to do that again.
And when you start plotting for this drive, when you start thinking to yourself, okay, what are we going to do? You don't go away from what you did before because that worked, but you have to be prepared for wrinkles and counters because you know they'll make some adjustments.
31 yards there and a first down. So the line of scrimmage moves all the way across the 50 now as they come up first and 10. Give him 5 on the carry there, and it'll be second down. Getting the sense, Charles, they're going to put a big emphasis this afternoon on the run game.
And why not? What we're seeing so far, It's working pretty well from them. And here's the best part. We always talk about the best performers do their job when the lights come on. I think he likes natural light best. Well, so many times we look at a short run and we praise the offense for trying to set the tempo and establish things, but the defensive guys, hey, they just won the battle there. It wasn't a big run given up. They don't always have to absorb the body blows. Sometimes they dish them out.
Nowhere to escape, and he goes down. Sacked there by Jadeveon Clowney.
Well, that play was the very definition of fast, quick, and in a hurry. Suddenly, he was there.
Yeah, blink of an eye, that happened fast and a big sack. So here we go. The offense is going to stay out there. They're going for it on fourth and eight. They'll drop the throw. He'll take a shot for the end zone. And they will not be able to hook up there. It's incomplete. Boy, it looked like he had it and dropped it. And the Falcons' defense stands tall. They'll get the football back. And this will probably be the last play of the quarter. Vick will look to throw on first down. Going up top. And that is caught. Touchdown, Falcons. Kelvin Benjamin, 55 yards. And the Falcons have taken the lead. Gonzalez good on the extra point. And that makes the score 14-7. Through one corner, 14-7 our score. Gonzalez now to kick this one away. That'll be taken in the end zone. And they'll start in a hole here as he's brought down at the 11-yard line.
Well, conventional football, football 101, tells us if you don't get it back to the 20-yard line on a kickoff return, that's a disappointment. But some of these team special teams coaches, with approval by the head coach, they give them full authority to go ahead and bring it out and try to be aggressive. Almost what we call the green light, red light theory. Green light means go. Red light means stop. Looks like he had green on that play.
A gain of three, second down. On second down, this is Jackson. And that'll hurt the average a bit as this time they're able to get him behind the line. Officially, it will go as a one-yard loss, and that's going to lead to a third down.
It's a loss of a yard. And it's third
ready, ready.
Down.
30 base. Hey, wahoo!
On third down, he'll drop to throw. He's got Evans. First catch there for Evans. Good enough for a first down.
But we're used to seeing the guy that you consider the number one receiver double covered. But how about this guy? He's double covered and finds a way to make the play for a first down.
That's how you increase your Madden rating, right?
No doubt about that at all. And you know something? I think we'll hear about that from him soon.
Up past the 25 to the 26, a gain of five.
I call that play a success. A nice inside run sets up a very manageable second down, a very solid gain on that play.
On second down, it's Jackson, and it's a fumble.
Wow, that ball gets knocked free, but a teammate comes along and scoops it up. It's almost like baseball. Guys at bat, people are on base in scoring position. One guy doesn't get them home. The next guy comes through and picks him up.
And avoids the turnover. On third down, they'll run it with Sanders. Well, they hit him in the backfield, and he will not escape. And that is not going to get it done. That'll make it fourth down after a loss of one. And how about this one now? In their own territory, a gutsy call. They're going to go for this on fourth and a yard. The Jaguars going to go ahead and use their first timeout. They'll have two remaining as we step aside here in this second quarter. And how about this one now? In their own territory, a gutsy call. They're going to go for this on fourth and a yard. They'll try and run for it. And he's going to have the first down yardage to the 35. Second quarter action with 1:59 remaining. Coming up at halftime in a little less than 2 minutes, we'll send you to Orlando where Jonathan Coachman is standing by. He'll have highlights and analysis of this first half. And hard running's going to get him over the 40 to the 42. A gain of four last play. They double that here and get eight. 8 yards the gain on that last run. Here's second and a couple. They'll run now with Bo Jackson. And he'll be taken down across the 50 at the 45 in enemy territory. That one good for a gain of 13 for Jacksonville and a first down.
First down, Jaguars.
We go, all runs on this drive so far. It's first and 10. On first and 10, it's Sanders. And he is going to be stopped cold behind the line of scrimmage. That's going to go as a loss of a yard, and it'll be second down.
Brings up second and 11 at the 46-yard line.
Maybe just a slight detour on what's been a strong drive. Here's second and 11. Second and 11. That's complete to Calvin Johnson. Touchdown, Jaguars! Calvin Johnson. 46 yards as they are an extra point away now from tying this football game. And correct me if I'm wrong, that was just a simple fly route, wasn't it?
No, there's nothing to correct at all. You've got it down pat. And I just remember as a player, when I'd be in practice sessions and I'd hear nine from the receivers, that meant fly route, go, look out. That was the nine, and he just kept going all the way into the end zone for the touchdown.
This will be taken in at the one. And he's up across the 25 and down at the 28-yard line. The Atlanta offense out there for their next drive. And we're under a minute to go here. What's been an even first half all tied up?
Yeah, still time to make something happen, too. Couple completions, you string them together. Could get into field goal range. Let's see what happens.
Check 50, check 50.
Alert 3.
Hayward.
First down, Vick. It got his man complete. And they've got it well across midfield, down to the 40 before it's all said and done. Give them 32 on the play.
Three down.
Hey, check. Three down. Watch 88.
Check 90.
Go.
99.
Hey, watch it.
Go.
Check.
Lucky.
Love.
From the gun, Vick being chased out left. Benjamin's got it, and they're able to get this one past the 30 down to the 25. Now the Falcons going to use one of their timeouts as the clock will stop with 21 seconds to go here in the first half. Operating on first down. He completes it to Jones. And he gets it inside the 10 to the 9. The Falcons going to use the second of their timeouts as it'll come with 15 seconds to play in the first half. Two big plays in succession. Not sure this D knows what hit them, but now they got to get ready. It's first and goal. Now a fake on the give here as they try the run pass option. And he'll take it into the end zone. Touchdown, Atlanta. A 9-yard touchdown grab as his guys are able to regain the lead. Gonzalez able to tack on to PAT, and the lead is now 21-14.
Jaguars 14.
after the touchdown. Here's Gonzalez on to kick it away. That'll be taken in the end zone. And not wanting to risk anything here late in the half, he'll just take a knee and they'll bring the football out to the 25. Jaguars come to the line to start their next drive. And with time quickly fading here in the second quarter, not sure how aggressively, offensively they want to play this.
I think we'll find out just how much they trust their guys in this situation if they decide to take a shot.
He's going
to
air one out. And that is incomplete, stopping the clock with 5 seconds to go. An incomplete pass leads to second and 10 from the 25.
Big stop, let's go!
Go Mike 50!
I'm here all day. Mike 50!
Get it!
They'll throw now on the final play. And he's gonna go down. Couldn't get a throw off with the pressure. Maybe that was for the best, as that brings us to the end of this first half of play. So we have reached halftime with a touchdown. That's the difference on the scoreboard. As we'll send you down to Orlando, we check in with Jonathan Coachman for our EA Sports Halftime Report. Coach. Okay, Coach. Appreciate it. A one-touchdown game here as we get set to resume play in the second half. The Falcons back to receive. They've got the lead, and they'll get this football as the second half gets underway. This is fielded a couple yards deep. And the decision to bring it out will cost him about 5 yards as he'll get this only back to the 20.
The Falcons take over first and 10 at their own 20-yard line.
About set to begin their next drive, the Falcons offense at the line. They have the lead now. They'll be looking for some separation here as we begin the third quarter.
I like the way you term that, because now I think they go a little bit deeper into their playbook. They like what they did in the first half. That worked okay. But in order to get the separation that you just talked about, change things up a little bit. Change your tendencies. Try and hit them a little bit more with some things they didn't see in the first half.
Let's see if they do just that. Operating from the 27 now. Here's second and 3. Stepping up. He's going to keep it. And he'll get it up near the 35, right at the 34 here. 7 yards there and a first down. From the 34 now, here's first and 10. This time they'll throw it with Vick. And that one's complete to Gurley. And able to get this one across the 45 before he's brought down. It's a gain of 13 and a first down for Atlanta. Vick and the offense will start first and 10. And he's 8 for 8 now, throwing the ball to start the game. And he's going to be met at the line of scrimmage and taken down. No gain there as he kept it himself at second down.
No gain on the play. Second and 10 at the 47-yard line.
Ready, ready. 50.
All day, dog.
Jim. Go.
Here comes the meat.
25. Check 25.
He didn't even try to signal for a timeout, so they must have not been aware of the numbers.
I think he lost track of the time left in the play clock and probably was trying to read the defense and trying to figure out which play to run and just lost track, and it cost him.
Second down, Vick. Eluding the... And a big loss pass here as he's taken down. Shaquille Barrett put that sack by his name in the stat sheet.
Well, this is what happens when you get behind the chains, as people like to say. When you have obvious passing situations, hard to vary it up and fool a defense.
And you hate those situations if you're an O-lineman, right?
Oh, without a doubt, because you just know they're coming, and you never know exactly how. They can be exotic in their blitzes, or their athletic ability just takes over.
Third and long for Vick. Got his man complete over the middle. That's Holt. Well, a heck of a play there on third down, but amazingly, they're still short for fourth.
I don't know how many times, not just in my playing career, but you and I working together, have we ever heard a coach say, you know, I just don't have that play on my call sheet. And that's really what we had here. That was a big hole they were trying to get out of.
Yeah, big gain, still a ways to go, though.
Now a fake on the give here as they try the run pass option. Looking left side, and he's got a man. That's Holt. And they'll get him down as he's inside the 40. Too far downfield, something those linemen have to watch out for, and that time it costs them. Here's Tressway now. And surprisingly, this is the first punt of the game for either team. And he gets it away, a directional kick going toward the sideline. And no return here. Where will they spot it? They say just outside the 20-yard line. Jaguars come to the line to start their next drive. They trail offense, first time to touch the ball in quarter three, and we'll see what they can do.
And I can't wait to see what they have planned, because some teams script to start a half. Other teams just go, okay, these are the sequence of plays we want to run. These things worked well for us. And sometimes they throw in that big chunk play right away.
Shocker.
Try and get after them early and try and create a big play to give themselves some momentum.
See what they have up their sleeve. It'll be a pickup of a couple, and it leaves him with a third and three.
But we just saw a great example of what we talked about with his coach prior to the game. He's definitely one of the better linebackers at reading the play and flowing to make the stop before it turns into something big.
They'll run again with Jackson. He'll have a first down past the 40, and he'll take it to the 43-yard line. A 14-yard first down pickup for the Jaguars. First down, Jackson. Credit him with a 1 yard gain there to make it second and nine.
He's brought down by Deion Jones. A gain of a yard brings up second and nine at the 44-yard line.
Got it. Here's second and nine, just a yard on that last run. And they're not going to get to the line to run another play. So we will switch ends as the third quarter has come to a close. You are watching Madden Ultimate Team on EA Sports.
Get in the white room. Get in the white room. Rush in. Rush in. 6-6. Pull it high. Hey, team six. Team six.
Shoot. Second and nine now. Trying to lay one up deep. Incomplete, almost intercepted. They haven't picked him off yet. Would have been a great time for the first, but instead it's third down.
Third down and 9 yards to go.
One of the bigger plays in the game thus far. The crowd getting into it as we come up on a big third down. Back to throw here. Looks to throw, fires right side. And that's going to be incomplete. The coverage too good there. The contact popped the ball free, and it's fourth down. One score down. Here we go. They're going to go for it here on fourth down.
Single receiver. I got 83.
Hey, Echo. Leo.
Check.
Go.
As expected, they're going for it to keep the drive alive. And an alley to run. And he returns it into enemy territory down to the 45-yard line.
Okay, it was fourth down, but you still had time here in the fourth quarter. Instead, they make the decision to go for it on their own side of the field, and this ball winds up getting intercepted.
We want this.
Check 52. Check 9.
So here's Vick following the interception. He's going to dump it off to Gurley. It'll be a gain of 6, and that'll make it second down.
Another nice pickup through the air, and I think a lot of people might expect him to run the ball in this situation, Brandon, but with this lead, they're electing to throw the football. Swings, slants, quick outs, things that they consider safe.
6 yards was the pickup on the last completion, so here's 2nd and 4. Now a fake on the give here as they try the run pass option. Throw left side complete. It's Holt. Touchdown, Falcons! In for the score. And the Falcons turn that interception into a touchdown. Gonzalez good on the extra point. And the lead now up to 14. Now after the touchdown, here's Gonzalez on to kick it away. This will be taken short. They'll bring it back to just about the 25, call it the 24-yard line. Jaguars come to the line to start their next drive. And following the interception, just any interception, are you a little bit more cautious when you start that next drive, or no, you just throw that out the window?
I think you are. I don't think that there's any way you can run back out there and go, totally didn't affect me. Let's just go ahead and be loose with the football again.
And this is intercepted, and that should do it. Picked off by the former USC man, Taylor Mays.
Partner, we always talk about possessions being at a premium in these games, and now in this situation, throwing an interception here when you have to claw your way back in, that one's going to hurt, and in a big way.
Gurley. And he'll have a gain of 3 to the 33. Got to figure now, after getting that turnover, they're just going to be happy to keep the ball on the ground, right?
This is where covering the football, taking care of the ball, all the ball security terms that have ever been used, they come into play for the guys on offense right now. Just take care of it, and they've got a good chance of ending up winning this game.
Kill, 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 turn up. Kill,
kill, kill, turn up. On 2nd and 7, Vick. And a big loss here as he's taken down. And now, defensively, they're going to burn their first timeout. Remember, they get an extra time built in coming up here shortly at the 2-minute warning. He gets this all the way down close to the 30-yard line. 2-score game here in the fourth, and that pick, it kind of keeps the door ajar, doesn't it?
It does, and you wonder about their strategy, because with a 2-score lead, you would think maybe you're just sitting on and trying to drain some clock. It's almost like they felt like, hey, we've got a good cushion. We can keep pressing it. It ended up costing them.
Trying to shake off the interception from the last drive. He'll look to throw. 6-time Pro Bowler Calvin Johnson, the intended target. And now it's 2nd down.
His struggles finding open receivers continue. I don't know the last time I saw him this inconsistent throwing the football.
It would be hard to find a date when he was this inconsistent. You know, in his locker, he keeps the word poise printed on an 8.5 by 11 sheet of paper. He needs to find that poise right now.
He certainly does. In fact, I would suggest he laminate it.
Hey, Haywood! Get ready!
Back to throw now on 2nd and 10. He'll find his tight end. That's Waller. 11 yards there for Jacksonville and a first down as well. So signs of life in what's been a dormant offense in this second half. Here's 1st and 10. 2 minutes left to play in this football game here on EA Sports. So it's Jaguar football here as we welcome you back. They've got a 1st and 10 as they search for a late score. Now on 1st down, he'll drop to throw it. That's caught by Jackson. This will be a 5-yard pickup as they move it from the 20 to the 15. 2nd and 5 after the 5-yard completion on 1st down. Second and 5. And this is caught down for a late touchdown. So hold everything here. This one's not over yet. Okay, game on. Don't go anywhere yet. You got a 1-score game now. Probably going to rely on the onside kick coming up.
Yeah, they have to. It's not a high percentage play, but it's better than not having a chance at all. And that's when you put your leapers and your flyers on one side, get that high hop, and hope that one of the guys can come up with it.
And on the other side, get that hands team ready.
No doubt about it.
Now after the touchdown, here's Gonzalez on to kick it away. And no return on this one as the fair catch is signaled for and taken.
The Falcons take over 1st and 10 at their own 25-yard line.
The Atlanta offense out there for their next drive. And this one now not quite over yet. Still 2 timeouts remaining defensively. And boy, having that 3rd timeout would have really helped here.
Another example of why coaches really stress saving your timeouts for when you absolutely have to have them. They go over this all the time. Here's one of those situations.
Taken down, but not before they work it across midfield. 25 yards there on the catch and run.
It's so important to tackle well against these guys, but you and I both know that's easier said than done when the guy you're trying to tackle looks like this guy.
And it's usually going to take more than one man to get him down, and it did right there. Now here's Vick. It's a short one here, complete to the tight end. And he'll go down shy of the 40 at the 41. The Jaguars now will use the last of their timeouts as they get the stoppage with 65 seconds remaining. Facing a 2nd and 2 after that last catch, good for 8 yards. They run out of the shotgun with Gurley. Oh, no, he lost the football. And the offense will get this one back. Boy, that could have been catastrophic at this late stage of the game, but they avoid disaster. The 1st down yardage to the 35. This time, good ball security and a good result. 1st and 10. Ball up to the 35 now as they come up on 1st and 10. Here's Gurley now out of the gun. And I think this defense knew what was coming as he is smothered behind the line. It'll be a loss of 1, and it'll be 2nd and 11. Oh, now look at this. They're lining up to add 3 more little insult to injury here late in the game. This to make it a 2-score game. And this is right down the middle as he puts it through. And that will extend their lead even further. So barring something extraordinary here in the closing stages, that field goal should just about put this one on ice.
Yeah, they've got to find two scores. So, you know, we're not going to exactly move it over there yet. It can be done. But, boy, it's going to be a little bit of a stretch for them, isn't it?
Yeah, they would have to move incredibly quick and have some luck, too. Jaguars come to the line to start their next drive. They might be thinking this is close to a lost cause here. Got to play it out. What do they need to do?
Well, they have a thought process in mind already, but they can't get ahead of themselves. They know that they need to score quickly.
Yep, two scoring. And this is intercepted, and that should do it. Brian Dawkins, the safety with a pick, and that will write a finish to this ball game. A lot of scoring. There's no doubt about that in this one, Charles. Points, they were not at a premium. They were pretty easy to come by.